So Mara, the stage is yours. Mara is the chief commercial officer of YEP, the number one, the biggest leader of in health and safety. They have the, they are really on the front stage nowadays. And Mara will talk to us of how it is to lead transformation with hashtag We Care. Mara, the stage is yours.
Thank you so much. So, hi all. Kalispera. And first of all, thank you, Georgia, and of course, YDC for the invitation and this unique opportunity to share our experiences with our co-members. So, as introduced, I'm Mara, and I'm the Chief Commercial Officer of GEP. GEP, as Georgia said, is the leading company in occupational health and safety in Greece. And just to give you a hint on the numbers, we are honored to cover and take care of the health and safety of more than 250,000 employees in 18,500 premises all over Greece. Starting the journey and going back to early February, at the beginning of the pandemic for us here in Greece, well, I have to admit that we were ultimately shocked, and I mean totally shocked, like the whole planet, of course, facing this new challenge. We were all wondering in the organization about what was going to happen, dealing with a huge wave of contradictory data that we were trying to collect in order to deal with the pandemic. Like most of the companies around the globe, we were trying to cope with our own continuity, focusing on our people's health and safety issues first, while at the same time, and as Georgia already said, we were suddenly at the center of attention for all our customers who were seeking for advice and support in terms of health and safety, of course, when we couldn't even support ourselves. So everything went disruptively fast. As you can remember back then, we had unknown data, a global panic, and an unprecedented crisis for the entire world. But as you can probably guess, GEP was responsible to support its customers. Our scientific teams needed to interpret global trends and best practices, local guidelines and regulations in order to take the lead and give a clear direction to organizations when everything was totally unclear at that time. And I'm sure you all remember it. So a few days later, in early March, I remember myself calling at night the CEO, everything happens at night, in early March, and telling him, you know what, I'm going to take a risk for GEP and I want you with me. I told him that I will not commercialize the fact. I will not take advantage commercially of the situation like our competition was already doing back then, but I will care. We will care for our customers and society. We will care for every single employee. We will embrace their fears. We'll give them our ultimate support. We will reposition ourselves as advisors, and we will reshape our role in the entire society. And really, that's what we did. With the hashtag WeCare, we started our own transformation. Working day and night, we managed to serve every customer's need. We supported and consulted them by any means. We designed new services. We created an R&D team, of course. We expanded our network of medical experts. We worked on every customer's project, case by case, and side by side with management teams and business owners to ensure that they can even exist, that they can be safe, that they can feel confident enough to work and produce results. So in 3 days, we set up a fully functional 24/7 call center of public health experts to support both medically, but also mentally, employees and their family members who were struggling to be fearless and understand what is going on. We ran numerous trainings, awareness campaigns, and web conferences with medical experts, sharing knowledge and advice on the pandemic. We placed doctors and nurses on sites who supported companies with their daily presence and their own call services 24/7. We arranged workplaces, designed health and safety protocols, run screening tests, and so many more. So here we are now, a few months later, and I can proudly tell you that we are capable to adapt in everything new. We're agile enough to lead the situation no matter what. And there's only one reason behind this. That's because we experienced our own victory. We found our why. We're living our why. And I'm moved to say that our people embraced change like never before because they have something to believe in. They embraced our new role. They felt totally engaged to that hashtag we care. They found their job meaning because we gave them the field to develop themselves. We gave them power by bringing our vision to life. And sharing this impact on the internal stakeholders, let me pass to the external stakeholders too. I mean our customers and partners. You saved us. We made it because of your support. We are expecting your daily newsletter every day for our own management meeting. These are quotes of our customers. This gives us the air we breathe. And you know what? The CFO is here, I may confirm. Of course, we increased sales volume. We even developed new revenue streams, but we worked for our why and money just followed. So one of the main lessons I learned is that no matter how much you try to work towards your vision, there are some critical times with urgency and fear that your vision is your only shield, protecting you from falling and keeping you safe. At these exact critical times, guys, you are blessed if you experience the power of living your own why and feel it in your bone. So if I can give a piece of advice here, that would be first and most important of all, take care of your health, protect yourselves, your family members, your colleagues, to the society. And right after this, grab your vision shield and your why weapon, and really everything becomes possible and nothing in the world can ever stop you. So thank you all and stay safe.
Thank you, Mara. This is very inspiring. Do we have any questions for Mara? Any hands? George, you need to help me if we have anything in the chat. Do we have anything in the chat? Or any questions? All right, let me ask you a question, Mara. If you were to do it again, would you change something?
I will maybe care a bit more for my personal hygiene to protect myself, my colleagues, all the peers, my family members, my mother, my father. I would protect them more. But okay. Everything else in terms of business, I wouldn't change a bit. Mm-hmm. Everything went exactly how it meant to be. And here we are now. GEP has a new role. GEP is the advisor of business, of Greek business network, but also for the entire society. So I wouldn't change a thing. I'm so motivated, I'm so passionate to bring support and advice on our customers. And this is our ultimate why of what I spoke about earlier.
Okay, thank you, Mara.